guys, so I got my water and let's get started on this review of Terry Goodkin's The Pillars of Creation. All right, so this one I really like. This one, I'm telling y'all right now, it has probably the least amount of Richard and Caitlin and Kara in it that I've ever seen in one of these books. One of Sword of Truth series books. And at first you think like, okay, it's gonna be bad because I saw a lot of reviews, people saying like, oh, it doesn't have enough Richard, Caitlyn. So you think like, oh man, it's gonna be bad. It's not at all. So spoilers. Okay, so this takes you through the supremely ungifted one, Jensen. And we know by the series, if you watch the Seeker series, that Jensen is his sister or half-sister. And so Jensen spends her entire life running from her father, which is Darkon Ra'll, because, of course, you know, he wants to kill all of his children who are ungifted. So Jensen runs, and she's with her mother, and she is, I almost have the whole book, but overall, she sees this guy with white hair, and he's cute, his name's Sebastian, and he goes, and he wiggles his way into her life. And the day he goes into her life is the day she loses her mother. And a bunch of the Haran soldiers comes and kills the mom. And she's now on the run with Sebastian. So this whole beginning, Jensen's story is actually really, really interesting, really good. You can feel how she feels. You can feel what she wants to do. And you can feel that she, her confusion. She's being, I'm just saying right now, it's a huge plot, you know, thing. She is being tricked throughout this entire book into thinking that Richard, her brother, is out to kill her. And as you know, of course, not really a big spoiler, because as you know, if you read the books, if you're really into the Sword of Truth series, you know that Richard is, of course, not out to kill his own sister. He does not even know she exists. And so, you know, as you know, Darkon Ra'll is dead. So, in the books, he's dead, at least. And so, she is running, and she is going on her own adventure, and she wants to see a swamp witch. And so, this swamp witch has been severely cursed with her own magic by Darkon Ra'll, the one who really was after Jensen. And she's cursed because she helped Jensen. And so, it's like, oh man, you know, this is so sad. That's a really cool part, you know, to travel the swamp, and she, it's really interesting. I don't want to tell too much, but it's really interesting. Then the main character I think you will find the most interesting and most entertaining is Oba. Oba is Richard's other brother. He's his half-brother, and he is the opposite of Jensen. He is more like Drefin Ra'll, if you read the other books. He's a bad guy, and he's got that same sickness that the Ra'll men seem to have. And they are, he's very, very violent. He loves killing and raping and hurting women. And he is a character that's going to make you hate him. He is living with his mother. His mother treats him like crap. And so at first you think like, oh, maybe, why is mom so mean to him? But then you notice that he's doing some sick stuff immediately. He sees a chicken in the yard, and he grabs the chicken, and he blows in his mouth. And when you read, you're like, what? Like, what's wrong? Why is he blowing in this chicken's mouth? And he grabs like a rat and bites his head off and drinks the blood. It's like, oh! And it's crazy because you think his mom is just drawing on him. But then he doesn't, like then you're like, oh, his mom got a reason. So this guy, Oba, is listening directly to the Keeper. The Keeper talks to Jensen and Oba through their mind. And Jensen ignores it, where Oba listens and talks back. And so in the end, Oba allows the Keeper to enter his body, and his life starts going up. After the Keeper enters into his body, he becomes invincible. And you'll hear that word a lot in this book, invincible. And Oba is so stupid and so annoying. He's got a Nathan feel to him, to be honest, because Nathan can be a little bit stupid and annoying too, but Nathan's a good guy with it. Oba is a sick, nasty, horrible monster, and he is really stupid. He thinks himself a hero. I love how the writer wrote this. I love how Terry wrote this. Oba talks like Richard in his own way. When you hear Oba's mind work, Oba talks like, I deserve this, and he's like, you know, my struggle, and I am trying to help, and I am, these women, they don't understand. And it's like this guy thinks he's a good guy. And he literally went to kill a man's wife, which was the sorceress. And I don't get into that too much. That's too much of a plot one. But he goes to kill her. It does not work. She ends up dead, though. And instead of being like, oh, let me leave, he takes the man's money and says, I deserve this because of all the hard work that I've done. Because she denied me the pleasure of killing her, I deserve this money. And he robs this man blind, and then he puts the money all over him, so it ties in different areas of his body, and says, I gotta make sure that nobody steals my money. There's so many thieves around here. Oba is not only is he a monster, but he's a hypocritical one, and that is what makes him so infuriating. And so, and then he'll just think about himself like, I'm not gonna forgive this, I'm not gonna tolerate this. And then he'll go turn around and kill a woman in such a brutally horrible fashion. And he even attacked the Mord Sif, and because he's supremely ungifted, that's a really cool part, when she uses her Agil on Oba, it doesn't work, and the Mord Sif relies heavily on her Agil. And so Oba's a big strong guy, and the thing is, though, she would still be able to kick his butt, but he had the Keeper in him, he had the Devil in him, so he was able to overpower her. But she gets away, and she ends up giving him a good roundhouse in his face, so he does not get the Mord Sif, which was a really intense part. So in the end, I'm not going to run the end for y'all, but I'm going to give y'all a guarantee. Oba gets what he deserves. I don't want to say too much, but Sebastian, he gets what he's supposed to get. And Jensen finds out that Richard is not the one trying to kill her, and she becomes part of the Seeker family. And that is a very, very sweet and touching part. And I truly enjoyed it. And I love this book. It definitely gets a 10 out of 10 for me. It puts a creation. No, Richard's not in it much. Richard comes in at about page 699 or page 700. Richard comes in really, really, really late in the book. But you'll be surprised how much you enjoy this. So that's basically it. Like I say in all my videos, I'm an author too. Check out my books in the links back at my channel. And I will talk to you guys later. Okay, guys. Bye.